Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll be talking about naming binary ionic compounds. Again, I am not an expert in the field of chemistry, but I will try to explain everything as simple and as easy to understand as possible based on how I understand it as a student. What is a binary ionic compound? It is composed of a single metal ion and a single non-metal ion. We have to keep in mind that a metal ion is called a cation and a non-metal ion is called an anion. Different elements can have different charges. We can easily remember those by looking at the periodic table and disregarding the transition metals for a while. In simpler words, group 1 is 1+, group 2 is 2+, group 3 is 3+, group 5 is 3-, group 6 is 2-, and group 7 is 1-. Noble gases are exempted since they are already stable atoms. Transition metals can have multiple charges, and you can look at this for a complete list of the most common charges. Ions form ionic compounds to become neutral, or in simpler words, the charges must add up to zero. Sodium is 1+, and chloride is 1-, so one of each makes the charge of sodium chloride zero already. Meanwhile, calcium is 2+, so it needs 2 chloride ions to have a neutral compound. In naming binary ionic compounds, the cation is written first, followed by the anion, but we put the suffix I. In the case of sodium and chlorine, we first write the cation sodium as it is, followed by the anion chlorine with the suffix I to become sodium chloride. Another example is lithium and bromine. We first write the cation lithium as it is, followed by the anion bromine with the suffix I, so it becomes lithium bromide. Take note that we do not put prefixes. When your cation is a transition metal, they can have multiple charges, so refer to the list I showed earlier. For example, copper can be 1+ or 2+, so we write that as Roman numerals like this. Copper 1 is a 1+ ion and copper 2 is a 2+ ion. In situations like this, the lower charge gets the suffix -us and the higher one gets the suffix -ic, so it becomes cupros for the 1+ copper and cupric for the 2+ copper. Now, in writing chemical formulas, we have to know the charges of each atoms involved. The idea is to crisscross the charges. In sodium chloride, sodium is 1+ and chlorine is 1-. So when we crisscross, it becomes like this. In potassium oxide, potassium is 1+ and oxygen is 2-. So when we crisscross, it should be like this. When we deal with transition metals that can have multiple charges, like ferric oxide or iron 3 oxide, we know that iron is a 3+ from the Roman numeral, and oxygen is a 2-. So when we crisscross, it becomes like this. We also have ferrous oxide or iron 2 oxide. The iron has a 2+ and oxygen is a 2-. So when we crisscross, it becomes like this. But another important rule is to keep the subscripts in the lowest possible ratio. So we divide both by 2 and it becomes like this. We will tackle the chemical nomenclature of covalent bonds and polyatomic atoms soon in our future videos. Leave your questions or suggestions in the comment section below. Like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you!